Hey guys, and welcome to the channel. In our previous video, how to use all trails for hiking and backpacking, there were a lot of questions about some additional features of the application. And so in today's video, we will answer one of them and we will talk about how to contribute a new trail to all trails app. And first of all, why would you contribute to all trails? You might be hiking in a remote area or in some uncharted territories, and you want to share with the community so that other people can have the same experience and enjoy it. In fact, this is how all trails works. It relies heavily on contributions from the community, whether it's reviews, maps, or photos. Now, the option to contribute to new trail is available on both the desktop or mobile app. And for this specific demo, I'm going to use the desktop application. So let's go ahead and get started. So first of all, you want to go to alltrails.com and you want to make sure that you are logged in to your account. And to the top right, right where you see your name, there is a drop down. You go ahead and click that and you go ahead and click stats. And on the right corner, you will be able to see contribute and a plus sign for adding a new trail. Once you click the add new trail, it's going to take you to this page here where you are going to do all your magic and create your new trail. And as you can see here, the first step is to find the starting location. Now, there are three different ways to find a starting location. The first one is to pan and zoom the map to your desired location. Second one is by entering the city or the name of the park in the search box. And the last option is by entering the latitude and longitude in decimal degree format if you happen to have that information. So for the sake of this demo, I'm gonna go ahead and enter the name of the park that I'm interested in, and it's gonna take me straight there on the map. The next step after finding your starting location is to create your route. And there are two options here. You can either draw your route or you can upload the file. And by uploading a file, I mean that you might have a route on your GPS and you do have a JPEG format file that you can extract and you should be able to upload it. We're gonna focus more on the first option by drawing your own route. If you look here to the top right, there are two options to create your route manually. The first one is routing and the second one is drawing. And I would say that the routing mode is probably the easiest and the simplest. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose the routing mode. And as you can see, there's also a drop down to specify what type of activity this trail is intended for. Is it for hiking? Is it backpacking, horseback riding, or mountain biking? And you basically just choose the activity that's relevant for what you're trying to do. Now, once you choose this mode, all you have to do to create a route from point A to point B is to click on a starting point and click on where you want to go. And the app has a smart capability and will automatically route you on the best path for the activity that you chose, which is awesome. And not only that, but it will also create a trail profile for you that will specify the distance and the elevation gain, and you should be able to visualize that in the chart in the bottom. And this is pretty much it for the second step. The next step is where you get to edit trail information by basically indicating the name of the trail, the difficulty level, the usage of the trail, what type of route is it? Is it a loop, point to point, out and back? You get to also specify activities on the trail. Is it intended for backpacking, hiking, camping? And you can enter as many information as you have about features, is it dog friendly or not, and so on. Now, once you enter all the information that you have, you want to go ahead and click save. And this is going to take you to a draft page with the trail that you just created. And it's going to basically look like any other trail that you would usually search for on all trails. It's going to show you the name of the trail, level of difficulty, distance, elevation gain, route type, and so on. Now, this is where you can add more details about the trail in terms of a description. So as you can see, you can go ahead and click add and create a detailed descriptions about the trail, trail profile, what to expect, what are the encounters on the trail, and so on. And you do have another option to also download some photos and write a review if you want to. And this is pretty much it for the trail creation. Now, if you look at the top, there is a blue bar with with a notification saying that the trail is basically pending approval and can only be viewed by you at this point. And this is just a notification to let you know that the team from All Trails is reviewing your submission. They're gonna look at your trail. Does it have all the necessary information? Is it accurate? They will probably look at maps and make sure that the information that you are providing is legit. And if they review it and they think it's good to go, they will approve it and it's going to be up and visible not only to you, but to all the All Trails users. And that's pretty much it. I hope that you guys found this video useful. And if you did, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to our channel. We are trekking pals, Habiba and Alex. We are amateur hikers and backpackers. We create video content every Tuesday about hiking adventures, how-to videos, and so on. Thank you again for watching, and we'll see you soon in another video.